is 91.1 The Avenue. I'm Amanda Sharon, joined now by the very talented singer-songwriter Adriel Denae. Adriel, thanks so much for joining me.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. We are so excited because you are part of the Gather on Broadway Farmers Market series, the Encore series. You're performing at Gather on Wednesday in downtown Green Bay in the Broadway District. And of course, our listeners know you well and know your music well. But what can folks expect for the show if they come on out on Wednesday?
Well, it's, you know, it'll be a new experience for me because I haven't visited Gather yet. And I'm really excited, you know, to see the space and be able to share music there. But I plan to play a set with my dad, Stu Heiss. Well, actually, he goes by Daniel Price now. He's just decided at 75. and he'll be playing guitar, and I'll play some songs on piano and some on guitar, and I'll do a mix of original songs and a few covers. It'll probably be more original, but we usually like to sprinkle a few covers in. We'll probably do an old standard or two, and I don't know. I don't know yet. We'll probably get together in the next couple of days and decide on the set list. But, you know, my dad and I, it's become one of the great joys of my life to get to play with him. And he's such a sensitive, gifted player. And he's really funny, too. So we kind of go on a little ride together every time that we play. And it's always different. But yeah, you can expect a few dad jokes probably, and I don't know, some heartfelt songs.
So what have you been up to lately? I know that you had your dad on stage with you, I think, at the Christmas show, right?
Oh yeah, at the PAC, the one that we did at the Ave.
Yeah.
That was the first, those were the first songs we'd played since the pandemic had started. That was a really, meaningful night, and that was one of the first times we'd played together, actually, just the two of us. That was a really special night. Yeah, we've done a handful of shows since then. You know, since live music has become more accessible again, as the pandemic has eased up, I've been, you know, just kind of trying to find my new footing with performance. It's something that I still feel drawn to do as a way to connect with others and connect with myself. But as I've been playing more with my dad, that's really added this new kind of dimension to playing music for others, just because getting to connect with him in that way is so meaningful and precious to me. Mm-hmm. And it's really important in our relationship also. So, you know, I kind of struggle to feel and know, you know, a strong sense of ambition in terms of, you know, building a career in music and gaining fans and that kind of thing. I just feel a little bit out of that trajectory, I guess. But mm-hmm. I really, really appreciate any chance that I do get to perform, because it's a really life-giving experience for me, even if I'm nervous leading up to it, just because I'm not doing it a ton. So yeah, I was really excited when Gather offered me a chance to do this, because I think getting to play music alongside a farmer's market and that kind of just energy of a community coming together and sharing and buying and trading from each other is just a really nice kind of atmosphere to bring my music into. So it feels mm-hmm. like a good fit. Mm-hmm. But yeah, what have I been up to? Let's see. Well, my son is just started third grade. We just, you know, started the school year. So I, along with probably many other parents in our community, feel a little bit, I don't know, what the word is, discombobulated.
I was just gonna say discombobulated.
Yes. No matter how much you think you've prepared or how much you think you're ready for the shift in rhythm, it's just, it feels like a freight train has rolled through. So we feel a little out of sorts, and we're rolling with it. But I had such a wonderful summer, just honestly falling in love with this area, even more so than I think I loved it before. We took a lot of opportunities to explore different state parks and county parks and get in the water as much as we could. And I just feel this, I don't know, I just feel so lucky to live where I live and to be able to enjoy the natural beauty of our region. And so as sad as I am that summer's ending and I know the long winter is approaching, I'm trying to just kind of sink into this transition. And I love the autumn and fall here. So I'm looking forward to that. But that's probably what I've been up to most, is just spending as much time as I can outside. And I have a small business that we run, out of Appleton with a couple of beautiful women. We make balm and herbal infused oils, and I've been working with a cooperative farm out in Plymouth in Sheboygan County to grow our herbs. So I spent a lot of time out there this summer, and so I don't know, I feel more rooted to our community up here, and that makes me feel really awesome. And I'm always playing music. I mean, I play my piano every day, or most days, I shouldn't say that. I definitely miss a few there. And I'm always writing, and music is my kind of primary way of connecting with myself and processing my feelings. So I hope to record this winter, do some home recordings and include my dad in on that and some of my close friends. And hopefully play, my goal is to play a couple times a month. That I feel like that's really good for me. So if anyone's listening and wants to book a show over the winter, let me know. But I'm just enjoying being here in Wisconsin and kind of finding deeper roots with my own little community here. That's what I've been up to.
Awesome. So you are performing at the Gather on Broadway Farmers Market series on Wednesday. Now, these are they're concerts that have been paid for by Nicolet Bank in advance in sort of an effort to try and, pay artists for their time and their art, not just doing like free live music or free shows. So the whole point is that, concert goers know that this is a paid show, but their ticket has been paid for in advance by Nicolet Bank. What do you think about that concept? It's sort of different. Nicolet Bank, a supporting partner of The Avenue.
Oh, I love it. I think it's so lovely. I think we're really lucky to live in an area that values live music, and to have, businesses and venues that are looking for ways to create experiences for people to connect and gather together, and that use their resources to make it doable for everyone involved. I think a lot of us, from artists and performers to people who would like to enjoy live music but may feel pressed financially, I think that when places like Gather and Nicolet are willing to work together in this way, it's a lovely investment, and it means a lot, to me as an artist to get to play and to be supported financially to do that and support myself and my son. And it's exciting too to just not have the barrier of a ticket price for people that might not be familiar with what I do but may be able to connect with me, because that barrier is lifted. So I think it's wonderful. I'm just grateful to be intersecting with, businesses and people that are thinking that way. It's fantastic.
Well, we're so excited for the show on Wednesday, and thank you so much for joining me today here on 91.1 The Avenue.
Thank you. And I just have to take this moment to thank The Avenue also for being such wonderful supporters of local music and our community in so many different ways. I love you all, always have, and I'm a big fan. So it's a pleasure to talk to you anytime, Amanda. Thank you.
Oh, thanks, Adriel. It's so nice to talk to you as well. I've been speaking with Adriel Dene here on 91.1 The Avenue. She's performing on Wednesday downtown Green Bay. Thanks again, Adriel.